corresponding to the richness of his glory. May he strengthen your inner selves with power through his Spirit. May Christ dwell in your hearts through faith. And may love be the root and foundation of your life. Thus you will be able to grasp fully with all the saints the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know that the love of Christ surpasses all knowledge, so that you will be filled with all the fullness of God. To him whose power now at work within us is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, to him the glory of the Church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, ages without end. Amen. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. And at that time, when Jesus came on a Sabbath to eat in the house of one of the leading Pharisees, they kept him under observation. There was a man right there in front of him, suffering from dropsy. Jesus asked the lawyers and the Pharisees, "Is it lawful to cure on the Sabbath or not?" But they kept silent, and he took the man and he healed him, and he sent him away. Then he addressed himself to them, saying, "If one of you has a son or an ox, and it falls into a well, will he not immediately retrieve it on the Sabbath day?" This they were incapable of answering. He then addressed a parable to the guests, noticing how they were trying to get the places of honor at table. When you are invited by someone to a wedding, do not sit in the place of honor, lest some greater dignitary has also been invited by the host, who will come to you and say, "This place is for this man," and then, shamefaced, you will proceed to take the lowest place. On the contrary, when you have been invited, go and sit in the lowest place, so that when your host comes to you, he will say, "My friend, come up higher." And then you will win the esteem of all those at table with you. For everyone who exalts himself shall be humbled, and he who humbles himself shall be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. We're all familiar with some of the biology that applies to sight. That if we happen to be in a dark room without any light for any extended period of time, and I'm suddenly thrust out into the light, our eyes cannot process the light, and we are temporarily blind. Or when the eye is overpowered by light, snow, there is snow, mountains full of snow, so if we coming snow blind, the eye cannot process the light. And so it is with the ability to see God. In order to see God, our humanity must have reached the capacity that is necessary, which is the great commandment. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, all your strength. Then, only then, can the person see God face to face. Because light becomes accustomed to the source of all blessings. The dynamic in the scripture readings today is the key to feeling the fullness of God, the key to experiencing the depth and the breadth and the height and the love of Christ. The key is the last line of the Gospel. Everyone who exalts himself shall be humbled. He who humbles himself shall be exalted. The human disease is pride. where the human being sets himself up or herself up as the be-all and the end-all. Human glory. And this causes blindness. This causes spiritual atrophy. It's only through self-emptying, or the humbling of self, which the epistle says, the root meaning of humbling oneself is the first, or the second line of the epistle. I kneel before the Father from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. We are engaged in the supreme act of humility in the sacrifice of the Mass that Christ has given us. The supreme act is to bend the knee and acknowledge the presence of the Father in His Son through the Holy Spirit. It's in this dynamic of worship and giving glory to God that is the antidote to human pride. And it's only when that is being addressed and this whole pattern that St. Paul talks about takes place in our life where we experience the fullness of God. Remember, heaven begins already in sacraments. It's not completely future. Heaven began the day with that dust. Why? Because God's very life, the Blessed Trinity, was introduced into our humanity, and we were made heavens. This is the meaning of material life. And all the sacraments exist to nourish and expand this presence of God, this fullness of God. But we all have resistance. And the resistance is pride. And therefore, the spiritual life is often referred to as a spiritual combat, a struggle. And this is where faith comes in. May Christ dwell in your hearts through faith. The willingness to accept the word of the Lord that our true well-being lies in self-emptying and turning our lives, losing our lives for Christ's sake. And it's not that any human trick or offer of earthly happiness that the world constantly puts before our faces. And let's face it, we're all tempted. I've mentioned this piece many times, but he was a master theologian and thinker. Father Romano Guardini has a series of meditations called Lord. And he's very honest. He says, listen, we have to admit in our heart of hearts, isn't what's out there, doesn't that appear more real than the gospel at times? Isn't the momentary good life, the beautiful people, the rich and the famous, boy, if I only had $1 million, boy, if I could fly first class, boy, if I could live in that house, boy, if I had that money, doesn't that seem more real in the hustle and bustle of the world than what we hear in church? And Romano Guardini, he asked that question, and he says it's not a sin to admit that. And many times, that seems much more, and people are saying, all these people seem to be getting ahead and doing very well, and we seem to be a little kind of stuck in, why am I feeling so bad at all this business? And he says, that has to come out. We have to address that. That's part of our resistance. We have to acknowledge it exists. It's only there that the act of faith says, Lord, I believe in your message and I want to guide my life, that we're constantly making an act of faith. And it's only through that process of overcoming and constantly telling the Lord, I believe you, I accept this in my life, I want to guide my life despite the appearances of other things, that the power that St. Paul talks about starts to become unleashed in our lives. The power that we can then grasp the fullness and the depth and the breadth of the love of Christ, which surpasses all happiness, all anything the world can give. But it's a day by day, constant response of struggle. And it's only through this constancy on our part, faithfulness, that the power of the Holy Spirit's power more and more becomes released, and the resistance in our hearts lessens and lessens. And this is the whole way we subject ourselves to the Word of God constantly, in the first part of the Mass. And then we receive the Eucharist, please God, as often as we can, we go to confession, because we're seeking spiritual aid to lessen the resistance, the false attraction, the deceptions of this world. And let's pray we all struggle with that. But this epistle is very beautiful, because it's in the act of kneeling before the Father, the act of worship, that we seek the glory of God, and the exact opposite of what our human tendency is. And then St. Paul says, your inner self will be strengthened with the power of the Holy Spirit, and you will begin to experience the depth and the love and the breadth and the height of the love of Christ, and feel the fullness of God. The fullness of God, experiencing the fullness of God is, again, the foretaste of heaven. That God is the source of all happiness, that God is really the be-all and the end, and His glory is the most important thing. This is the whole root meaning of Sacred Heart Devotion. A lot of people, you know, people say, well, that's just some devotion, we don't need that. Well, they don't understand the gospel. Well, this text is often used in the Sacred Heart Devotion. The whole point of the Sacred Heart reaching out to us is that we can know the depth of the love of Christ for each one of us. That we would be overwhelmed if we allow our resistance lessons and we allow Christ's love to take over. It's an overwhelming love, and then you can see how the saints act. St. Paul, for example. St. Paul, his whole life was response to the overwhelming love of Jesus Christ. St. Ignatius Loyola, that's the whole basis of the spiritual exercises. So let us, as we continue on Mass, ask for that healing and lessening of resistance, giving glory to God as often as we can, so that we can experience what St. Paul talks about,